Hello, and welcome to another bite-sized video on qTest. In this video, we will cover the import Excel functionality in qTest. We'll take a look at what this functionality does, where within qTest you can use it, and how. Equally important is also why it's worth following a few best practices when using the import Excel functionality, so we will also cover these. QTest Manager allows you to import test cases within the test design section. However, before going through the import process, let's first walk through some best practices. The easiest way to ensure that your Excel sheet is in the proper format is to download the sample import template and then fill out the information in that spreadsheet. To do so, select the Import Excel icon and then select the hyperlink Sample Import Template. Once it's downloaded, go ahead and open up the template. It's now time to fill in your test case information. I've already filled out a sample file, so I'll display that in order to best walk you through the proper practices. First, make sure that you're aware of which fields in your qTest project are required. These fields will have to be included and filled out in the Excel sheet. The test case name is always required, so make sure to fill that field in. This applies to any custom fields as well. For example, in my project, the custom field Webinar Best is required. So, I know that I will have to include and fill out that field in the Excel sheet. Also, please note that on my sheet, the field Subtype is in place of the field Type, which is standard in the sample import template. I made this change to reflect my own project field settings. In my project, I have replaced the field Type with the field Subtype. If your Excel sheet is going to include any custom fields, make sure that these custom fields are created and active in your project field settings. Please note, you'll have to be a project admin to manage the project field settings. To access your field settings, select the gear icon and choose Field Settings. As you can see, I've already added the two custom fields in my sheet, Owner and Webinar Best. The next step you want to do is to decide if you want these test cases to be stored in a new module or within an existing module. If you want them to be stored in an existing module, you must rename the Excel sheet as the module number and module name. For example, I want to import the test cases in an existing module. My module number is module 22, and the name is New User Signups. So I named my Excel sheet MD-22 New User Signups. Before I import this Excel sheet, take a quick second to recognize that the test case ID field is left blank. This is because I am importing brand new test cases, and in this situation, qTest will not allow me to fill in this field. This is happening because qTest will automatically give my imported test cases the proper test case ID. Now, if you're importing or updating test case information for already existing test cases, you would fill out this field. Now, I am ready to import my three new test cases into qTest Manager. I will select my project in the navigation panel and select the Import Excel icon. I will then select my Excel sheet and click Next. I'll go ahead and map my Excel spreadsheet column values on my qTest field values. Remember, do not map the field test case ID when you want to import brand new test cases. Once I'm done mapping the values, I will click Import. When the import is finished, I will click OK and refresh. The next thing you want to do is to look at the module in which you had told qTest to import your test cases. In my case, as expected, my three test cases are here, and their fields are filled out just as they were in the Excel sheet. Now, congratulations, you've successfully learned how to import test cases in the qTest from an Excel spreadsheet.